on constitutional reforms has up to now visited 14 districts, and we started this process on the 1st of February. Before that, we had sessions in Colombo for 5 days, and it was very successful, because this is the first time in the history of our country that the people have been consulted before drafting a constitution. Right, so we are asking the people, what type of constitution do you want, and what is the nature of the constitution, and what are your problems, and what do you expect from the constitution? So we have been doing that very successfully, and the cooperation that we received from the media and from the people are tremendous. Right? So up to now, in Colombo, we interviewed over 259 persons in Colombo during that 5 days. And up to now, we have interviewed over 1,400 persons, right? And we are also collecting material in the sense submissions by way of emails, fax messages, and some people hand over in writing to our office at Visumpai in Colombo, and also sometimes when we go out stations. So we spend 2 days in each district, right? except for Colombo, where we spend 5 days. And up to now, 1,400 people have come before us, and about 460 odd emails, and about 80 to 90 fax messages, and in writing about 400 we have got in writing, right? So altogether over 2,000 persons have made submissions before us. So we have to visit another 11 districts, right, during the next 2-3 weeks, and in March, after we finish those districts, in March we hope to get back to Colombo and hold sessions in Visumpai, where we'll be hearing submissions from, we'll say, professional associations, trade unions, the clergy, religious associations, and things like that. And also we'll visit certain districts where we think that there are more people who are waiting to make submissions. So that will be decided in March. In any case, on March 3rd, 4th, and 5th, we'll be sitting in Colombo.
So the date is extended?
Date extended, yeah. For written submission, up to 10th of March, now we are extending. 10th March, right? Now, the main thing that we see now is that earlier the people thought that the constitution was for lawyers, judges, and constitutional experts. This is the first time that the people have come to know that it is their constitution. Right? A constitution is necessary for the people. For constitution is necessary for the people to protect themselves from a strong state. Right? Because state machinery is so strong that the people need a constitution to protect their rights. During the last few years, we have seen that the people could not protect themselves using the constitution, right? Because people are harassed, disappearances, killings, murders, or everything happened. Even the chief justice was just thrown out, but there was nothing could happen under the constitution. So now we want to have a strong constitution, where the people will not suffer again like this, and they will be able to fight any state, any government, by using the provisions of the constitution. Right? Therefore, that is our aim. And today the people have the most beneficial thing that has happened is that now people in the buses discuss about the constitution. Right? In the shops they discuss about the constitution. On the road they discuss about the constitution. So this means now the constitution has gone to the people. Right? So that is a very good sign, where people will know what their rights are and where to find those rights, instead of just submitting to the suppression or the oppression that is on them. Now we are here even in Jaffna, we were surprised that some of the ways
you
in which...
You have got any value of it?
Yeah, very valuable. In Jaffna, Jaffna was really, I would say, the most valuable. Because we have got to know now how they suffered during the war, right? How now that it, for them to come out, what should be done? Right? War victims of war has to be rehabilitated. There's no doubt about it. And that had not happened to the extent that it should have. Like 7 years after the end of war, right? Should not have. And secondly, we were surprised at the caste oppression that they responded, and that is seems to be a serious problem here, right? So we have to see that justice is done, right? We can only recommend is for Parliament to ultimately decide what the constitution is going to be, and so what we can do is help Parliament by telling them this is what we saw in the district, right? And recommending that to say that this is what we recommend. Right? So that's all what we can do. And we are thankful to the media for having given us the fullest support.
Yes,
and we expect the same support in the days to come.
Okay. Thank you.